back to part two of what apparently is turning into a fiasco. The editing's not going well, and neither is the fate of the Crown Vic. Ooh, yummy. You think rodents have been in here? Hey, that's where that nozzle from the vacuum cleaner went. Let's see, here's my EGR. Oh, yummy. Look at all of this. Yummy. A lot of deposit right there. Oh, this is so gross. All right, now to the manifold. Look, that's where the plastic came from. There's pieces of it. I don't know what this goo is. It's all covered with carbon. That rubber seal is completely mushed. Looks almost like it melted. That one there, that seal's completely gone. So back here was where it initially started leaking. See the black all over the seal right here. The outside of this is all gone. Let's see. Any telltale signs here? 5/10/2013. That one's okay. This was where the majority of the leak was. Or at least I thought it was. Curious where those pieces of plastic came from. There's supposed to be a ridge all the way around this. And you see part of it right here, part of it right here, but this is missing, this is missing. And somehow it got from here over into here. After a rainy, miserable weekend, we're gonna try to get some more work done on the Crown Vic. We've got it all cleaned up. And we're ready to put the new intake manifold in. And let's see, I'd like to do a shout out to AM Auto Parts in Green Road, Olathe, Kansas. Getting this manifold out to me very quickly. Bag of goodies. Same deal we took out. No differences at all. There it looks exactly the same. Stands are in the same place. everything on here looks the same. I want you guys to see the difference between this right here and that right there. This is what happens when you have this chemical, I believe is called 2-EHL. Let me check that. All right, now look at the difference between that one right there and that one right there. This right here is caused by a chemical that's added into the coolant that you want to avoid. This right here is the 2-EHA, is a cost-effective but controversial additive that softens plastics, particularly silicone, leading to leaks and affected sealing materials, which means the silicone cannot be used in gaskets, O-rings, or hoses if antifreeze contains 2-EHA. So what we're going to be doing is we're going to be replacing this with gold long life that does not contain the 2-EHA. Nothing is pinched underneath it. Okay, something is not sitting right. That's not cool.
Yep.
So this thing's got a little bit of a warp to it. Hopefully we can get the warp out of it. Now we've got our bolts all cleaned up. Put on some Permatex. Lubricate those threads. Now let's go ahead and drop in all of our anti-seized bolts. Drop them all in. Just the ones that hold it down the manifold. Let's put the front ones in here just to help for the alignment. ahead and start tightening all of these down. Finger snug. Working in a crisscross pattern, starting in the middle, tighten them all down to about 9 foot-pounds. And then go back and tighten them all down again, same pattern, to 18 foot-pounds. Transfer your sensors over. And go ahead and snug those down. Tighter than maybe you would make a spark plug, but now just before you get ready to put the intake fuel rail on, make sure that all the holes that they're going to go down into are smooth and free and clean. The last thing you want to do is go jamming an O-ring down on top of a damaged surface. Molding crap. All looks good. Alright, now we're going to grab some silicone spray and we're going to basically just give them a little spritz to help them slide in. Take your spray with your ejectors facing away from you, just a little spritz on the O-rings. Take our rail, get all the way back where it goes. A little more wiggle around a little bit, get some of the silicone worked around the O-rings. Make sure you get those O-rings all worked all the way down in. A little bit of silicone on the O-rings. They generally slide right down in very easily. All right, go ahead and transfer your rail tie down bolts. All of these have already been anti-seized also. These are all 7 or 8 millimeter. Thank you. so well. Okay. Snug those all the way down. Go ahead and put the alternator support bracket back in place. I gotta go under or over the wiring. I think that's gonna go under the wiring. Yeah, the wiring goes underneath the bracket. Okay. Above, or do we want that below? Push it down like that, I think everything fits. One bolt right here goes in the back of the alternator. And then transfer the other two bolts. Also a really good time to clean out this throttle body. This is kind of getting a little nasty in there. You can see all the way down in there, that's just kind of gross. So we're gonna go clean this up before we put this on. All right, put the throttle body back on in place. Throttle body's all cleaned out. Set it right here, just like that. And go grab the bolts. These are already also anti-seized. There's a total of 5 of them. Spin all of those down in. And these are also 18 foot-pounds. Double check them. Now go back to the one oddball over here. And then get the EGR hooked up. It's a 10 millimeter. Now let's get some of this wiring in place. Some of this wiring. One, two, there. So all of our wires are hooked up over on this side. Everything's hooked up over here. That's supposed to go there, but that broke off. Let's go over to the other side. Get all this wiring in place. This goes on here to ground the fuel rail. Make sure you ground your fuel rail. This is for the EGR vacuum control. Let's see. Everything else here is looking good. Vacuum hose. Obviously this one goes here, and this one goes here. And the vacuum hose goes there, but there's a little tree of vacuum hoses that goes in here yet. I'll go ahead and get these fuel lines hooked up. Simply just insert them gently, and then click in and lock. Click in and lock. Make sure you put the safety latches back over the top of them. The other side, that little hose clamp in place, right back in its little witness marks. We're gonna hook the back heater hose up. Now, try to keep this in such a way that you can actually get at it. That hose good and tight. Okay. Get those vacuum hoses. Throttle cable's over. Our EGR control is mounted to these cables. Gotta figure out which way the routing goes here. Let's get back around this way. Sits right here. There. And so I gotta take this back out. Drop that down. Put this here. Hook the cables back up before I put those bolts back in, just in case. Hoses are hooked up and plugged in. That's got to get run all the way down. Well, these cables are supposed to be underneath those. We're going to have to reroute those. And then we got this little metal bracket right here to hold it in. We need the two screws for this. back off again. This one back off again. These go down here. And these cables snap into their respective little holders back here. And get in here and get the PCV hooked up. Everything over on this side except for spark plug wires is done. I'm going to pull the plugs out because I want to make sure I didn't get any coolant down inside there. I'm sure I got coolant in the block, in the cylinders. So I'm going to crank it over a couple times without the plugs in it. Yeah, let's see, let's make sure everything on the other side's all done. Now, the kit gave us a brand new O-ring and a brand new cheap piece of junk thermostat. We're not going to use this one. We're going to use the Made in America Ford unit. And we're just going to hold right in there like that. Drop the bolts down in. And make sure when you're putting your thermostat in that your spring is facing down towards the engine block. You have to work both of these down evenly. About 18 foot-pounds also. Let me go ahead and hook the radiator hose back up. We've gotten all the spark plugs out, cleaned everything out, cranked the engine over, cleared everything out. Now we're just going to put all of our wires back down. All the spark plugs are in and torqued. Click. Not sure why that didn't click. That one clicked. Why did this one click? There we go. That clicked. vacuum hose back down. Where is it? There it is. Everything's all hooked back up. Just gonna put the intake back on it, put the relays back in, and crank it up. Relays back in. All right, let's see, moment of truth. Are we ready to fire it up? Let's see what happens. Find a couple of times. We have any leaks? Nothing's wet. Goody. All right, let's go ahead and start it. Like that one, please feel free to like, comment, and subscribe. Don't forget to click that notification bell. And don't forget, you got no more excuses. Pick up those wrenches.